Lucia.
Hey, Tiara. Guess what? KMTV's back. What?
Okay, give me 30 seconds.
Okay, I'll see you.
Welcome back, everyone. I'm Maddie.
And I'm Lucia. Today is Friday, September 4th, 2020.
And you're watching Around the Mountain.
Stay tuned to see all our new segments that we have prepared for this year. Trust me, you won't regret it.
On this day in 1972, Mark Spitz placed first and set world records in all four individual men's events he entered at the Games in Munich. The 100-meter and 200-meter freestyle, 51.2 seconds and 1 minute 52.8 seconds, and the butterfly over the same distances, 54.3 seconds and 2 minutes 7 seconds. Also on this day in 1981, 39 years ago, Beyoncé Knowles was born. Happy birthday, Beyoncé.
Hey Maddie, did you know, even though we're online for school, there are still lots of things you can do?
I know, right? I just found out that DECA, the business club, is having a meeting September 9th at 2 o'clock p.m. Join the Remind at KMHS DECA 21 for more information.
That's so cool. I just found out that Key Club, a community service-based club at our school, is also starting meetings. For more information, you can join their Remind at KMHS KC20 for more information.
That's great. There's also the Speakers League, a club to help improve speaking skills. Join their Remind at KMHS Speak.
That's so cool. Well, how are these clubs going to recruit and get to know the freshmen?
Well, let's get to know the freshmen right now.
Kennesaw's freshman feature.
Hey Mustangs, I know we're all super excited for the 2020 football season, and you're probably wondering, what will our Friday night games look like? Watch this video to understand and see the expectations for every game.
Hey, put your mask on!
Mask on.
All fans are required to wear a mask at all times.
All guests will answer screening questions and have their temperature taken before entering.
When you arrive in the stands, you will see these stickers.
There needs to be one student on one sticker. Please do not gather in groups. If social distancing is not being followed, the Kilt Squad will lead you in this chant to help.
Hey, yo, social distancing check. Give me two claps and a Ric Flair. Hey Mustang family, super excited to see you guys Friday night.
Make sure you're social distancing, and it's now required for fans to wear a mask.
If you can't comply, you will be asked to leave.
And if you can't follow the rules, just don't plan on coming.
Mask on, get mask on, mask on, get mask on, mask on.
Hi Mustangs, it's Braden Sperry. Our Mustangs varsity football team will have their first game of the season versus East Paulding tonight at 7:30. All tickets must be purchased through GoFan, and no tickets will be sold at the door. This week's theme is Country Camo Out. Come support your Mustangs at the home opener. Boys and girls varsity cross country will be competing in the Cobb County Championships at Allatoona Creek Park starting at 8 a.m. tomorrow. Good luck, Mustangs. Congratulations to this week's Otters Chicken Athlete of the Week, Junior Emily Maddox. Emily helped the varsity volleyball team reach the championship last weekend at North Forsyth. Way to go, Emily.
Gotta be aware of the inbounder here if you're filling.
Toothpaste?
No, elephant toothpaste.
Wait, what's that?
Stay tuned to figure out how to make it.
Hey guys, it's Alexa from KMTV.
Hey guys, it's Allie from KMTV, and welcome to
Weird Science.
Weird Science.
Today we're making elephant toothpaste.
You're going to need 1/2 cup of hydrogen peroxide, 1 tablespoon of yeast, food coloring of your choice, dish soap, a cup or glass, and 2 tablespoons of warm water.
Okay, so first you need to get 2 tablespoons of water. And mix that with 1 tablespoon of yeast.
And put that in there and mix it until all the yeast is dissolved in the water.
The next step is to add 1/2 cup of hydrogen peroxide into an empty bottle.
Then you're gonna add 1 squirt of dish soap.
And then add food coloring. We're going with blue. I think that's enough.
So the yeast acts as a catalyst in this reaction, and the dish soap traps all of the oxygen in this reaction, and that's what makes it go.
Okay, now we add our yeast mixture. Wow. And that's how you make elephant toothpaste. Signing off, this is Allie Burns from KMTV.
I'm Alexa Andres, signing off. Stay tuned for another episode of Weird Science.
Whoa, did you just write with your right and left hand?
I'm ambidextrous.
Ambidextrous. The definition is, able to use the right and left hands equally well. Come back next week for a new word of the day.
On Sunday, August 30th, India broke the world record for the largest spike of cases during the pandemic so far, with around 79,000 new cases being registered that day, according to data from Johns Hopkins University. At the time that I am filming this, India has around 3.6 million cases and 64,526 deaths. Unfortunately, these rates are only the third highest in the entire world. So, who has the most cases? Well, the United States has around 6 million nationwide. And getting more local, Cobb County, where we live, has just a bit under 17,000.
According to the World Health Organization, there are currently 8 vaccines that have made it to phase 3, which means that they're still going through trials and no one knows exactly when one will be available for use.
So let this serve as a reminder that this pandemic is not over and you still need to be following CDC guidelines in regards for the safety and health of others and yourself.
Don't you just miss school so much?
I miss it so much. I can't wait to be back. But guess what? Yesterday, the Media Center just said that if we want to get books from the Media Center, we can do a curbside pickup. And for more information, you can go on mainmedia.info-blog.
That is so exciting. But guess what happened in chemistry today? This kid kept eating. It was so annoying. He was one of those people.
Wait, what do you mean by one of those people?
Keep watching this segment to find out.
Hello, Jesse? Are you there? Nobody can hear you. I think you're frozen.
This class is so boring.
I did not mean that. I am so sorry.
Okay, class, if everyone could turn their cameras on, please. Dora, will you turn your camera on, please? Okay, I'm gonna have to mark you absent if I can't see you.
So yeah, today I went to the grocery store with my mom and like we got some milk and then we went home and like we saw my dog and I think I'm getting a new dog. I don't know. Like I think I want a German Shepherd or something. I don't know. I'm gonna have to convince my mom and my dad. I don't know. Like my sister's allergic to dogs, so we may not be able to get one, but I don't really care. Like
were taken before quarantine. Please stay away from your friends and maintain socially distanced. Inappropriate video submissions will not be viewed or used by KMTV. Inappropriate submissions can cause nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, runny nose, and constipation. Thanks, Kennesaw. Have a nice day.
Hey, Lucia, you're a senior, right?
Yeah, class of 21, baby.
Did you know that they're doing college tours online now?
Wait, really? That's so cool. Where can I learn more?
Go to the KMHS website under Naviance for more information.
That's amazing. Well, I have a question for you, Maddie. Who do you think's a pretty cool senior?
Well, let's find out.
This week's Senior Spotlight is dedicated to Lexi Houston. She was nominated by head cheer coach Eliza Midlow for the 2020 Georgia Cheerleader of the Year and made it into the top 30. Judged on academic performance, community service, cheer ability, and a minimum GPA threshold to even be eligible. Lexi will compete for the title of Cheerleader of the Year via video submission. Now, here's Lexi answering some questions from home.
So to be considered for Cheerleader of the Year, it just makes me feel very honored because this is such a great opportunity and a great experience. And it just means so much to me to be selected to compete because this sport is my love and I've been doing it for so many years. So this is super exciting.
Hey, this is Siri, and I will be asking some of the girls in KMTV questions today. Question number one, what do you think about when you're alone in the car?
I don't think.
I think about if I'm about to go through this green light that just turned green, what if somebody's trying to run this red light for them that just turned red?
And I just get smacked.
I'm always just worried about getting in a wreck.
Well, let's say hypothetically that every night I drive home from work and sit at the same red light and wonder what would happen if I threw myself out into the middle of the intersection and ended up in the hospital. Who would come see me? Who would care? You know, the huge. I also like to listen to music.
Question number two. If you could marry any celebrity, who would it be?
I'd get married to Harry Styles in a heartbeat. And the color theme would be pink and blue. Honestly, I would let it be up to him because he got it all.
This is actually a great question because it is not hypothetical. Timothy Chalamet and I will be getting married in August 2026. I know it seems like a while from now, but my 26th year plan will be commencing very soon.
Question number three. If a 6-year-old asked you if Santa was real, what would you say?
I would tell them yes, because it's not my job to you know, scar other people and ruin their lives. That's society's job, okay?
I mean, don't want to, like, ruin his hopes and dreams that, like, Santa really comes down his chimney on Christmas Eve and stuff. I mean, yeah, I guess so.
I'd have to say that if a child asked me if Santa was real or not, I would say no.
Last question. What movie traumatized you as a child?
Number one, Coraline. I'm not even gonna get started on the buttons for eyes. Sewing on the buttons for eyes when she went in the other world or whatever it was. I don't even know what the plot is anymore because it's been that long since I watched it, because who wants to voluntarily watch that? Never again. No. Coraline is on another level of creepy.
E.T. is not a scary movie at all, but you would have to pay me to watch it. Like, I don't want to watch it, and I will never watch it again.
All right, those were all the questions. Thanks for listening, Kennesaw.
Hello, everyone. I'm Claire Tallman, and I'm going to be this week's weather woman. I looked up what happens when it's sunny outside, and the only thing I could get was what happens when it's sunny outside in Ireland.
Guys, I'm Claire Tallman.
Claire Tallman, here today as your weather woman. I'm going to be telling you the weather for the next couple days, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Here's Friday's weather. And we have a high of 91 and a low of 70. And then here's Saturday's, which is a high of 90 and a low of 70. And then Sunday, it gets a little bit cooler and it's gonna be a high of 85 and a low of 68, I believe. I'm gonna tell you what you guys can do out in the weather and the nice sunshine that we're gonna be provided with this weekend. You can hit the courts, the golf course, lay in the sun.
If you don't get burnt, just be lucky because everybody in Ireland does.
Reporting at you guys, Claire Tallman. Have a good weekend. I am out.
Hey Kennesaw, it's Izzy DeLuca here reporting on your positive news story for today. The Smithsonian National Zoo's very own giant panda Mei Zhang gave birth to her seventh cub 2 weeks ago on Friday night, August 21st.
Mei Zhang is 22 years old and was artificially inseminated on March 22nd, 2020 with the help of her panda mate Tian Tian. Fans watched on the live birth cam as the cub came into the world at 6:35 p.m. Giant pandas are an endangered species, and only 2,060 remain in the wild today. Conservation efforts such as this one are made in hopes of saving the species.
Thanks for watching, Kennesaw. Tune in every Friday for more good news stories.
That's all we have for today, Kennesaw.
For more information about KMTV, don't forget to follow us on Instagram, YouTube, and Twitter.
We have a lot of great plans this year.
I'm Lucia.
And I'm Maddie. See you next week.